Hello and welcome to this video on creating and using an invoice for domestic reverse charge. So what I'm going to show you today is how you can make a template for domestic reverse charge, and I'm going to show you how you will use it. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to go into tools and we need to go into the print template editor. What will happen is you will get the print template and report designer, and what we're going to do is we're going to open up an invoice template that we already use. So you can see here, you might have your recently used templates and it could be here, or you need to go to open template and then you need to select invoice and then you need to select that template. So we're going to click on invoice on here and we're going to click OK. So this is going to bring up my invoice template that I currently use, but I need to make some modifications to make a domestic reverse charge invoice. Now the three things that we need to change is we need to change in the table, we need to put a tax description that shows the domestic reverse charge and the percentage. And then we also need to put some wording at the bottom here to say that it's domestic reverse charge invoice, and we're also going to put domestic reverse charge amount as well. Right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to click on to this table on here. And these are the general properties of that table, and you can see that you've got a preview here, which we'll come back to in a minute. But we're going to go into columns first, and what we need to do is add a column. So I'm going to click on the plus sign and I'm going to click on standard column. By default, that's going to be at the bottom at the moment, which is perfectly fine whilst we create this particular column. So in my column text, I am just going to put tax description. Once you put in that column text, you can go into field name, and we're going to find tax code dot description. So if we go right to the bottom here, we should see tax code dot description, which is here. Now you can also, if you want to, if you prefer to, you can put tax dot description and rate, which we'll put the rate as a separate part. But some people, most people, might have put in their domestic reverse charge on tax codes, the whole thing in the description anyway, but I can leave that up to you. Okay, so I'm going to put tax code dot description. Now you can see here that's come still at the bottom, but it's put in the right information that I need. But the next thing that I want to do is format the horizontal alignment to make sure it wraps, just in case my description is quite big for my tax code in terms of domestic reverse charge. So I'm going to make sure it wraps as well. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put that up a couple of spaces so it falls between description and then price each. So just in between there, we've got tax description. So as you can see here, we're starting to see a preview that we've got here. Now we can click refresh, that will just change it. Now what will happen is obviously at the moment, the tax description width is probably not great, probably at 100, and I might need to make that bigger. What I might need to do is I might decrease my description here just a tiny little bit, just in case my description is there, but I can make sure that that wraps as well. So if it does go over a little bit, it will go on to the second line, which will be absolutely fine. You can obviously mess around with these kind of widths, and you can decide which is better for you once you print it, and you can sort of go back into the template and modify it. So that's the template sorted, and probably the hardest part of this particular exercise. So that's one bit that we've done. So it's now going to show the tax description of the individual items that you put on your invoice. Now what we're going to do is we're going to scroll down a little bit and we're going to concentrate on the footer down here. So what you do need to put is you do need to put some wording in. And I'm just going to drag that wording in over to here so you can see how that's used. But first we need to build what we call a text box. So we're going to click on this text box on here. And I'm going to decide that I want my wording just around about here somewhere. Okay, so I've got my text box. I can now double click on that text box and then I can put the wording that I require. Now I'm going to put the wording that we found on the government website, and this might be the one that you will use. So the wording we've got here is customer to account to HMRC for the reverse charge output tax on the VAT exclusive price of items marked reserve charge at the relevant VAT rate as shown above. So we're going to click OK and that's going to populate in there. Now what the next thing we could do as well is we could actually put how much the domestic reverse charge is. That will give the customer the information that they need to pay HMRC a relevant amount of money or pass it on to their end user. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on insert text element here and I'm just going to put it down here and I'm going to put in domestic reverse charge, and then we got that in there. And that'll be my first line item. And then what I can then do is put my tag next to it, which is going to be on this right-hand side just down here. And if we scroll all the way down, we're going to find one called Total DRC Calculated. So I'm going to populate that into here, and that's going to come up. Now, what we need to do is we do need to go back into this Total DRC Calculated, and then we need to click on the Format Mask and make sure it's set to currency. Just double check that it's set to currency so it shows in the pound sign. What you can do is you can change your font, you can change the style. So for example, if you want it bold, you'd be able to do that. So that's possible if you want to. Okay, so I'm going to okay that. We've now got that in there. So the next thing that we need to do, and this is a very important part of the process, is click on the Save As button here, because we don't want to overwrite the original invoice that we had before. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to template name, and I'm going to say invoice DRC, and I'm going to put click just so we've got a different name to the other ones that I've been previously doing. And I'm going to click on domestic reverse charge. This is very important. So when you print out your template and it recognizes that it's got domestic reverse charge on it, it will always default to these types of templates. So we're going to click on OK, and that's now saved. So let's have a little look to see what that looks like in Clik. Okay, so we're in Clik now. What we're going to do is we're going to click on an invoice. We are going to go into a invoice, and we're going to quickly create one. So I'm going to add some products. I'm going to add that to my invoice. Now, when I add that to my invoice and I want it to now be a domestic reverse charge, I can change the tax code from here. However, if that customer was set to have always that tax code, that would also populate straight away from here. And you can see that you've got these elements at the bottom now. So you've got the DRC rate and the DRC amount, and you can see that the VAT has now disappeared completely. So what we're going to do is we're going to click OK on there. We'll just click close. And now you're going to see that widget in there. And you'll notice this box in the bottom right hand side just saying domestic reverse charge £16, but no tax as expected. So what we're going to do now is I'm just going to show you what we're going to print out that template that we just created. So if we click on print, we say yes. And you'll notice that it's directed us straight to the invoice DRC click, because that was ticked as a DRC template. And I'm going to click on OK, and then we can see the changes that we made. So as you can see, you've got your tax description in there, domestic reverse charge 20%, and it's nicely wrapped up. And down here, we've got customer account to HMRC for the reverse charge, output tax on the VAT exclusive price of items marked reverse charge at the relevant VAT rate as shown above. So it's telling you it's a reverse charge invoice, and you can see here that's the domestic reverse charge amount, and you can see that there is no VAT. Okay, that's it for creating and using a domestic reverse charge invoice. Thanks very much for listening.